I'm trying a new backdrop for Bits and Bytes. Feedback has not been good. On today's broadcast, learn about top technology from the Finovate Spring 2016 event, two lessons you should learn from a Salesforce database outage, hear top technology tips from industry experts, and more. So get ready, FPPad Bits and Bytes begins now. Hey everyone, I'm Bill Winterberg, and thank you for joining me for this week's Advisor Technology News broadcast. Today's episode is brought to you by Riskalyze, the company that invented the risk number and twice named as one of the world's 10 most innovative companies in finance by Fast Company magazine. Advisors use Riskalyze to show prospects they're invested wrong and prove to clients they're invested right. See how Riskalyze creates fearless investors by visiting riskalyze.com/fppad to book a guided tour. This week's top story covers the Finovate Spring 2016 event held earlier this week in San Jose, California. With over 70 demos spread across 2 days, here are my picks for the most promising solutions for financial advisors. First is IBM, as the company demoed its Client Insight for Wealth Management solution, designed to deliver better insights about your clients powered by, you guessed it, IBM Analytics. The Client Insight dashboard segments your clients by their behavioral profiles, predicts the likelihood of clients experiencing a significant life event, and automatically generates a list of top actions clients should take to make progress on their financial goals. The analytics-powered insight is great, but it's not yet clear to me if the solution is something you can buy today or if it requires integration with the technology providers that you use, particularly with your CRM software. One third-party example I can think of is the automated investment service from Marstone, which to me still seems to be evolving and appears to be rolling out at a very measured pace. So if you want to start seeing some of these cognitive powered insights in the tools you use, I think you need to prepare to spend a little bit more on your technology to make these benefits a reality. The second demo of note came from InvestNet, as the company highlighted AdvisorNow, which is now being positioned as an online financial planning tool that can be white-labeled by financial institutions or you, the independent financial advisor. AdvisorNow's capabilities are quite a bit different than this time last year when the solution was first announced, as InvestNet is further leveraging its technology acquisitions of Upside, Yodlee, and Finance Logics. Next week, I'm headed to the InvestNet Advisor Summit in Chicago, where I plan to get more details on AdvisorNow. But in the meantime, you can watch a recent AdvisorNow demo from Finovate Europe by visiting fppad.com/187, where I've linked it along with this week's top stories. Next up is news on Salesforce, as the company unfortunately suffered a failure in one of its critical databases this week, affecting several thousand of its customers in North America. The outage of the NA14 database lasted for about a day and a half, causing many users to publicly vent their frustrations on Twitter. Now, closer to home, I didn't hear from any advisors who were affected by the downtime, which is good, but there are still two lessons I want you to take away from this incident. First, when you use any cloud-based system, especially a CRM, be absolutely certain that you have an offline backup of the critical information you need to take care of clients. Make it a part of your process now to export data like names, phone numbers, and email addresses so you can stay in touch with clients if and when your online systems have extended downtime. And second, make plans now for what you're going to do when your firm experiences a crisis. How will you contact clients? Will you post information on your website or provide updates on Twitter? Whatever you do, identify your process in your disaster recovery and business continuity plan. And if it's been a while since you last tested your communication in a crisis, well, you might want to do something about that. And finally, wrapping up this week's broadcast is news from Shareholder Service Group, as I attended their annual conference in San Diego a few weeks ago. One of the general sessions I attended was a panel discussion on technology opportunities that lie ahead for independent financial advisors. So I caught up with each of the panelists, Greg Friedman of Private Ocean, Dave Welling of SS&C Advisory Market Group, Tim Welsh of Nexus Strategy, and Joel Bruckenstein of Technology Tools for Today, to get their main takeaways from the session and hear their best advice for advisors from a technology perspective. The full video from the event is embedded over on the website, along with a few additional stories that didn't make this week's broadcast, so head over to fppad.com/187 to get all the details on this week's top advisor technology news. Remember, Bits and Bytes exists because of the support of our sponsors. So be sure to check out Riskalyze and learn how you can use the risk number to engage prospects and prove to your clients that they're invested right. Visit riskalyze.com/fppad to book a guided tour of Riskalyze today. Now for this week's poll on YouTube. Do you see yourself using cognitive insights to influence the advice you give to clients? Let me know by choosing an answer embedded right over here if you're watching this video on YouTube. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Bill Winterberg. See you next time. That can be white labeled by financial institutions or you, the financial advisor, the independent financial advisor, affecting several thousand of, caught up with each of the three panelists.